Greetings to you, Crocodoc Army. Anyone who creates any sort of art or entertainment is bound to upset some people. And the larger and more diverse your audience, the more people you'll upset. I've certainly run into that myself, more every year, and I think most of you would agree that I'm not the most controversial personality around. The common bond that ties nearly all of the Crocodoc Army together is simply lack of religion or belief in a deity. The further I stray from that very narrow baseline idea, I know there will be more dissent, and that's okay. If you create any sort of content and angry dissent is not okay with you, then you're probably better off creating makeup tutorials or vlogs about your daily life. The newspaper Charlie Hebdo certainly knew it was controversial and knew the potential dangers, but their senseless and barbaric deaths, of course, still make me sad. I understand what drives them to speak out because it drives me too. As with all killings, there's no shortage of vultures trying to score some political points from it. Fox News made mention of a gun control angle a couple times, implying that perhaps this attack wouldn't have been successful if there were more good guys with guns, as they like to put it, despite knowing at least two police officers, one of whom was Muslim, and the personal bodyguard of one of the cartoonists were among the dead. Bill Donahue of the Catholic League also had some interesting thoughts on the killings. He said that if the paper's publisher had not been so narcissistic, he may still be alive today. He also said that we should not tolerate the kind of intolerance that the newspaper showed. While he didn't excuse the violence that happened, he said that Muslims were right to be angry. It's no surprise that Donahue understands what the terrorists feel like. He has a hard time separating attacks on him from attacks on his religion, too, and he agrees that gay people are sinners. The whole article can be summed up as him saying, "You shouldn't kill people, but your level of outrage is totally understandable." In another facepalm-worthy newscast, Fox News analyst Ralph Peters chided Democrats for being against waterboarding and other forms of torture for terrorism suspects while discussing the attacks. Meanwhile, one of the stated reasons for the radicalization of these Islamist terrorists in the first place, and surely countless others around the world, were those pictures of the widespread torture going on in Abu Ghraib during the Iraq War. It certainly doesn't excuse any radicals from their crimes, but every time we torture someone, we hand terrorist recruiters a gift-wrapped present to help them carry out their work. The other present comes in the form of our reaction to the attacks, and what we say that it says about Muslims in general. Islamic terror groups want to foment hatred between Westerners and the Muslim populations in Western countries. I never believed Islam as a religion of peace any more than Christianity is, but whenever I hear people say, "Hey, look what the religion of peace just did," I immediately add intellectual laziness to their list of personality traits. Jihadist recruiters love that rhetoric. So what should we do about this? Keeping tabs on specific Muslims who've been voicing jihadist ideas or other red flags is a good idea, of course, as the Paris attackers had been at one point. The other 4 million Muslims in France managed to not kill anyone in a terrorist attack for years, and yet there are people calling for them all to be watched more closely now, which is exactly the wrong approach. There have been several attacks on Muslims in mosques in the wake of the attacks, which is again music to jihadist ears, as are people who think they're doing a public service by sounding the alarm against all Muslims. Islam is neither necessary nor sufficient to carry out mass killings, and fortunately most of the actual experts in the risk intelligence community are behind the scenes, not giving completely amateur opinions on Fox News or on YouTube. Meanwhile, we in the West will continue to help mainstream Muslims fight jihadists, honor free expression, and protect law-abiding, non-violent people of every religion and no religion. Speak out if you can do so safely until you can speak no more.